The backhand winner at the point of complete exhaustion. It was a battle of wills. It was a battle of endurance. And it is finally over. 3 hours on the butt. How about that?
And on her first match point, Cohen able to take it, and she can't believe it. And it couldn't have come too soon. She was laboring physically, had given it all she had, has left everything out on the court, both players, but Cohen, a lot of miles covered in this match. And credit to this opponent to come up with the goods, and that's all you can do as a tennis player, as a competitive player out there.
Well, you can see it and you can hear it. Being iced down nearly completely is Julia Cohen from Philadelphia, trying to stave off the cramps. She'll rehydrate as quickly as possible. But you know exactly, Chanda, what that pain is like.
Well, not quite that kind of pain, because I have never cramped or felt that bad after the end of a match. But, you know, these two players, you know, they left everything out there. And I know what that feels like, to just have no energy left emotionally as well as physically. And make no mistake about it, this was an emotional and a mental battle as much as it was physical. And Cohen really showed that she has the goods out there mentally to compete with anyone.
All smiles now with the help of the training staff. Lots of ice, lots of fluids necessary. Somehow able in that last game, Chanda, to battle through the cramps where she could barely stand up and play so well.
Well, I almost can't believe it's over. I mean, that's how long the match went on, and perhaps Cohen felt the same way. But she deserves a little special treatment here after coming through the way she did, and certainly winning has to make the muscles feel a whole lot better.
And of course, match point had to be a marathon point, right?
And there was nothing less we would have expected. And the net court there from Merrick and Cohen taking advantage. One of the few times she's taken that backhand up the line, and she did it at the biggest point possible.
Only her second backhand winner of the match, and it comes on match point. Adam Zucker will wrap up our coverage. What a way to finish up Cohen through to the second round of the qualies.
Dave and Chanda, thank you so much. An endurance test, and Julia Cohen wins it and apparently doesn't want to leave the court yet after a three-hour, three-set marathon against Tadija Marić, and Cohen will surely enjoy a day off tomorrow. Of course, Dave and Chanda, we'll see you back here for day two of qualies tomorrow. Day one got started for us here on CBS Sports Network at 1 Eastern Time. Shahar Peyer, the number one seed in women's qualies, ousted by Ksenia Pervak, 6-4, 7-6. Robbie Ginepri, he's played in 12 straight U.S. Open main draws, a winner, 6-4, 7-6 over Giovanni Lapenti. Ivo Karlovic, the two seed on the men's quali side, 6-3, 6-4. Over Mackie McDonald as he recovers from viral meningitis, does Karlovic, and look at this height differential between those two. Melanie Udan, she reached the quarters back in 2009, the 23 seed here, but falling to Alina Baltacha, 6-1, 3-6, 6-2, and Jameer Jenkins on the men's side. Despite repeated visits to the trainer, the NCAA tournament MVP out of University of Virginia over Gerald Meltzer. And then we saw Donald Young taking 9 straight games to win his match against Matthew Barton. And he goes out a winner today as well. Day one of qualies as these athletes try to win 3 matches before things are over on Friday. And once again, Julia Cohen, a winner tonight over Marić, and off to a nice day of rest. No rest for us, though. Day two of qualies beginning at 1 Eastern time tomorrow. Among the Americans, we'll see 17-year-old Taylor Townsend. She reached number one in the ITF junior rankings last year. For Dave Ryan, Shanda Rubin, Todd Martin, Andrew Catalan, Taylor Dent, Katrina Adams and Iron Tire Crew, I'm Adam Zucker. For scores, highlights, features, and more, go to CBSSports.com. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network. We'll see you back here tomorrow for day two of U.S. Open qualifying at 1 p.m. Eastern time, live from Flushing Meadows, Queens, in New York City. Good night.